Welcome back to Thionite Does the Gossip of the Napons. Oh, so wish of selling ware on breezy buoyant boat on sea top? Is such levness existing possibly? Meh. Personally, more of a land-based Napon, not much inclined to build such levness. Nautical navigation. Welcome back, one and all. We are here. We found the ship. All we had to do was come to Corn Island with this Napon camp on Corn Island. It's self-evident where we are because this is a Napon camp on Corn Island. That is the ship. We've tracked it down. We're starting off strong. Where is everyone? Are they dead? Are they all right? We must save them. And save them, we absolutely shall. Over there. Oh, nope. It's Dana. Oh, sorry, you guys. Looks like things went sparks up. Who attacked you? Her hurt. What situation? Details. Dana, please. Oh. Oh, that's not good. How did this happen? Over there. Agni and Levnesses. Yeah, no mistaking it. Oh, it's that stupid son of a gun. We need to eliminate him now. He has cost us the life of our friend. Hey, check it out. Looks like Ouroboros caught wind of us. Ragsy, I hope you know you're going to die for that. It was you. You took Levnesses to raid the shipment. Raid? I resent that wording. We just did what we had to get our food back. Oh, I hope you know that the price of that food is your life. Or what, you really thought we'd hand it over to our mortal enemies? You're dumber than the bale of tent cloth we sleep in. They're not your enemies. Shut your lying mouth, Mutter. You're as bad as a lot of them, a perversion of the natural order. You're not leaving me any choice here. We'll just have to get rid of you as well. Man, you have no idea what hell you've unleashed upon yourself. Guess we're doing this then. Lands, as if there was any other way of doing this. You cost Dana her life. You have to die now. Things have gotten serious. There is no words left to say. You just got to be destroyed. Old regime loyalists. Start by taking on these Tetsudos. At level 63, they're actually a decently strong force to be reckoned with, but I am not going to worry overly much. We focus down on one at a time. Focus on the Tetsudos. Go for all of the bonus effects. Get lucky sevens as quick as you can, and it will turn out wonderfully. Tion is unfortunately defeated, but that's fine. That is ultimately fine. As long as you're not taking down Noah, go for the break. It's resisted. So yeah, that's fine. None of these dudes have enraged statuses. They're not super unique monsters, so we don't have to worry about that. The ones with the blade arms will spin around, and I believe that's an AoE. You don't have to worry about that overly much. Oh, got that smash attack? Nice. Go for the back attack. Oh, lucky sevens. Oh, yeah. Let's just draw this. Having Noah have lucky sevens as well as Ethos class is an incredible pairing. Being able to instantaneously get that boost from Ethel's skills is just very, very good. Tachyon Wave, mastered skills, awesome. Go for a Dimension Ripper and the Nightbreaker, get that debuff, get the Tachyon Slash, and hopefully we can fight one of these Avises. Okay, there we go. Well, hopefully we can fight this Avis as well. Worst comes to worst, we'll just use the chain attack to defeat it, but I don't foresee that being an incredibly necessary thing. Launch, can we get the smash? Oh, we can get this. Oh, yep, there's the smash. By the power of lucky sevens, it's just so powerful. Go for the combo. Break, topple, launch, smash. Destroyed. Justice has been served. Or, well, it will be served. You're still alive. Ugh. We were no match for him, even with a Levness. Everyone, are you all right? Unfortunately not, Seeker. Oh, Snuff. Seeker. Timely entrance, you rat. Yeah, we're fine, but we were too late to help Dana and the others. What did you do? How could you? You're seriously gonna give me that? You, with the internal affairs background? We don't have two potatoes to rub together ourselves, but here's you handing over food to prisoners. You were perfectly content making the prisoners make our food and their necessities right up until now. And what do we care about anyone outside of Agnes? Let them all starve, I say. What, you want to argue? Some things are bigger than you or me. Things we can't achieve alone. We'll never have understanding without humility. What are you yakking on about? Without cooperation, there can be no escape from suffering. Not for any of us. Open your eyes. Don't you get it? Keeping the city's residents prisoner was the first fundamental wrong. Swallowing the console's words wholesale, that was another. Accepting the fake queen, another one still. If you can't comprehend, well, that may be as well. However, plotting against those who've turned over a new leaf will not be tolerated. Tolerated? Listen to yourself. I took up arms to protect the castle. Oh, spare me. You attacked and killed an innocent bystander. If you don't know how to be ashamed, you'll have to be taught. Take him away. What? Seeker, you worthless mutter. What gives you the right? Oi, face me. What a wretched turn of events. I should have foreseen this. You didn't cause this, Seeker. Not only will we fail to deliver on the promised shipment, now the passengers are dead too. I should be ashamed of myself. Now ain't the time for the blame game. We gotta do what we gotta do. You're right about that. I'll retrieve the goods and head back. Thank you very much for your cooperation, everyone. It's quite all right. Just wish it couldn't have turned out better. Why'd things turn out like this? I know. We'll have to notify Gondor of Dana's passing. I'll carry back her personal effects. I'd like to hand them over to Gondor personally, and tell her of what happened. In that case, why don't we go with you? I'm sorry. I feel as if this is something I have to take care of myself. I don't want to make you all carry my failure like that. Well then, I'll go on ahead. I'm really sorry for causing you so much trouble. And that for nothing. Think it'll be okay? With Seeker and Gondor? Yeah, I'm sure it will. Yeah, no matter her behavior, Gondor's not unreasonable. Much as we might want to, I don't think there's anything else for us to do here. Yeah, better leave it to Seeker, like he wanted. Oh, that is a quest complete, but it is not a very good ending. The ship Dana was on was attacked by rebels. The attacker's mastermind, Ragsy, was stopped, but Dana's life couldn't be saved. I see some relations have changed. Unfortunately, we get stark reminders that this is still a war every time we think we're clear. We free colonies, we defeat consoles. But we can't protect everyone from everything. That is unfortunately the reality of the current situation. I suppose we should go back and check at the castle to make sure everything is still good. I know Seeker wanted to take care of it himself, but by the time we get back up there, hopefully he'll have enough time to have dealt with that. We have returned to the castle. Hopefully everything looks relatively good as it can be, I should say. Augie, how are you doing? You have new things to say, I have new ears to listen with. I made a proposal to get control over the Eastern Island, but it got shot down. What, you mean? M'lady and Seeker told us not to do it, so we can hardly launch a rogue mission now. M'lady's having a real hard time at the moment. I'm gutted that we can't offer her much support right now. Don't you worry one bit, Augie. We will offer our own support to Gondor very soon. We won't have to worry about much. Or, well, she won't have to worry about much, and it looks like everything is, relatively calm in the castle for the moment. So, if there's nothing else for us to do over here, nothing new with Gondor and everything else is fine, I suppose the next court of order of the court, port of call, the next thing of business that we have to take care of, let's make the most of our break, guys, is actually we're finally getting around to these two things. Well, we'll get around to curious about training momentarily. We'll be doing nautical navigation first, a bit of gossip that we got from the Notpon earlier this episode. Riku, mate, are you piloting technique? Ahem, no need to say in words, Riku know already. Riku's handling of boundaries so splendid, make friend want to shower compliments? No, actually it's the literal opposite. Do you always have to make turning so sharp, it makes me seasick as all snuff? Meh? Oh, I'm sorry, but me too. Meh? To be perfectly frank, same here. Meh? Seems like there's maybe some room for improvement then, wouldn't you agree? Meh. Riku is not to blame. Always steer exactly like directed. Since friends keep changing destination willy-nilly, cannot keep straight course. Please do improve direction giving also. Ah, I see what you're saying. And yeah, that's fair. We'll try to do better at the bearings department. If friends aware, then no problem. Riku will also do best to steer gently. Just please not to throw up complaints. We won't throw up any more complaints so long as we don't throw up any more lunches. Trust me, if things don't improve, it won't be complaints that I throw up. Next time, Riku, my chum, you'll be cleaning up the chum of the world. Doesn't matter. Now that the piloting talk has left the building, curious about training. This one has been on the docket for quite some time, and if it's what I think it is, it will be a very beneficial one indeed. Let's lay out the facts. Right. Before or now, I couldn't tell which one was tougher. What are we talking about, Lance? Normally, the topics can vary wildly at this table, but, you know, sometimes we need a bit more direction. Nothing really specific. I was just thinking about the training regime those lost numbers go through. I hear it's a real gauntlet. That's how you toughen up, ain't it? Not that I'd want to sign up myself. Right? Ours wasn't pleasant at all. But when it boils down to it, I think it's the trainees who are better off, yeah? Compared to what we're doing now. Exactly, yeah. Life was a lot easier back when we were new recruits, right? That does make a kind of sense. All we do these days is fighting, and then more fighting. I mean, it's for the greater good, you know. Fighting Mobius is one thing, and lifting dumbbells is quite another. But, yeah, we get you, Lance. What sort of training do you think they actually go through? You curious too, Senna? You want to come with? We can check it out together. Oh, yeah, now you're talking. It's always fun to shop around for some new exercises. You lot are really getting into this idea. The training ground should be near the dormitory. I think we spent the night there once. Yeah, let's drop by when we're in the area. Side story, Lands. Alright, this is not the one that I thought it was, but it is as equally as important. Can I word that sentence any more stupidly? Probably, knowing me. We will absolutely be doing Lands' EuroQuest because that is something we very much want to do.
So you wish to utilize this thing of which I meant to dispose? Such daring lunacy. That is what I would dub it.
It would be a dreadful waste to throw it away. There's always a use. Always. People, lives, the lot. Why?
I stand corrected. Then, what manner of use is it that you have envisioned?
The lost numbers.
The city ruffians. You do know, no life can be harvested therefrom.
Yes. I am aware. That's why I'll have my toy soldiers play a little game. The lives of the fallen will be amassed in this special flame clock as a reward for the final lass or lad left standing.
Oh.
The cream of the crop of youth competing for glory. Oh. Is that not simply sublime?
I have the strangest feeling that Mobius is on the rise. More antics are coming. Lands, I need you to keep your eyes peeled. I have a feeling in my gut and in my sword that Mobius antics are soon to follow. Noah, you really need to calm down. They're always up to something.
Oh, Lance, you're a glutton for punishment, ain't ya?
Don't tell me you aren't curious, too. I want to know all their tricks of the trade.
In the meantime, while we wait for Mobius to reveal their hand and play their cards, we are going to talk training, because there is always a greater strength to reach.
Six ain't many.
Six of what now?
The Ouroboros candidates. All that training, and six get in.
Oh yeah, Monica did say something like that to us.
I feel kind of let down.
How so?
Just knowing there's a pecking order here too makes them the same. Same as us.
People aren't equally suited to everything. Such is life.
Sure, I guess, but...
I'm feeling hungry. You guys want to go grab a bite?
I'm in favor.
How about the shopping area? I found the tastiest looking torpedo stand. How's that sound? Torpedo wraps, eh? Spark, yes. Lance?
Yeah, sure thing.
Torpedoes it is, then. Lance, unfortunately, seems a bit pensive at the moment. Hopefully, a wonderful torpedo rap will be able to knock him right out of that funk. Oh, Romero, how you been doing? How's, isn't your beloved in the lost numbers at this point? Juliet is putting my skills to shame. She makes her marks as easy as she breathes. Wow, she's that good, is she? If fivefold I should train my limbs a day, a candle I would never hold to her. My heart is glad in knowing that we fight to rid the world of Mobius in full. Yet more still do I fear her well-being. Now Garrett's hesitance is all too clear.
I see some relations have changed.
Well, he may be hesitant. Well, he obviously would be hesitant to involve his daughter in a war where the mortality rate we have proven is very high indeed.
The shop that sells them should be just across the bridge.
I do love those torpedo wraps. Oh, this is a new shop. Shenna, you did find a new one. Oh, I would very much like to try a new one indeed. Maybe they have new recipes.
Hey, you! What are you doing back here? How many times have I told you, no performing out here?
You shouldn't be wasting your time like this. Don't you have training?
I'm not wasting my time. This is my job here.
You call that a job?
Hey, you're Ouroboros, right? I've heard. I suppose my job doesn't really compare to yours, I'll admit.
Why are they on your case?
Street performance. It's not allowed on this road.
Street performance?
This stuff. Around this spot, this is where you get the best crowds. But still, they like to push me around. We're at war here. Why aren't you fighting? They say.
Do you not need to be fighting?
The city's army is just for volunteers. There's plenty who are willing.
Why is that?
Because it gets you others' approval.
Yeah, well, it would, wouldn't it?
You think so?
You don't?
Well, who decides what has merit? And whoever's making the rules, how do we know they're right? I mean, I don't really know anything. It's just... I think... Isn't it fine if there's, like, one guy who makes the call for himself? You know?
Even if it ends up being pointless?
Hey, even pointless things can have a point. Down the line. I want to live my way. Take it one step at a time, the way I want. Really live. Oh, rats! Better scarp up before the guards find me again.
Hey!
Tell you what, I've got a new trick, just in the works. You should come and watch. Bye!
You okay there? Can I help out?
Nah. I'm all good.
Lance! This alarm's worrying. Head for the war room.
Right. On it.
We never got to eat any torpedo wraps.
Sorry, but the war room should be our top priority right now.
Yeah, we're definitely going to have to take a rain check on those torpedo wraps. Delicious though they may be, we really can't afford to skip out on any potential things that might require our attention.
A cradle transport for the colonies?
Yes. The report is calling it large scale.
And you want to liberate it? Like you did that last batch?
Right, well, that explains the emergency assembly.
When? Where?
By our estimate, tomorrow, late night. Podesto Valley floor, at the Great Sword's base. Boss, the logistics guys wanted an overnight camping kind of deal.
Approved. Sort out the planning.
Just what I thought you'd say, so I took initiative. We can leave any time.
What do you think? Should we lend them a hand with it?
Yeah, gladly. If Monica's okay with it.
It's up to you. But if things don't go to plan, there might be a fight.
We're prepared for that.
Then be my guest. Take this chance to show my soldiers that Ouroboros spark. It'll be an illuminating experience for them, fighting or not.
All right. We'll drill them well.
Drill them well, we will. We will absolutely pound it into their heads the high standards by which Ouroboros operates. Apparently, an entire cradle transport is being pulled off, which is very much something we want to involve ourselves in. If we can save even one cradle worth of soldiers, well, that is an entire cradle worth of soldiers that don't have to be forcibly put into this terrible, terrible cycle of pain and suffering that is this war. So I suppose we need to get to Cadencia post haste. All right, we are on the boundary, and I would like to take a quick moment to make a point of where we actually are, because this does happen to be a rather out of the way location that took me quite a long time to find on my first playthrough. So Essentially, you want to go to Centridge Harbor. You essentially want to come over here, hop on your boat, and go all the way up around over here. You want to pull a U-turn, essentially, right around here. There will be a beach, and if you hit this beach, you're in the right place, because there is another real sharp turn that leads back in this area. I found that beach in my first playthrough, but being unobservant, I did not find this area for, like, an hour, so definitely want to be aware of the fact that there is this tiny little path back out here to exactly where you want to go. So this is our meeting point. This is where we're going to make camp until the raid later tonight. So we definitely want to be here. The Morak Inlet. This is our location, and this is where we're going to stage this rescue operation.
Things used to be easier, huh?
What was?
All we had to do was bash heads. No thinking, no nothing.
What about the dying part? You weren't scared?
Sure, I was scared. But at least I knew what was expected of me.
Wait a sec. You want to go back to that?
Obviously not. Just saying how I feel. There's just too much snuff to consider nowadays. It's doing my nut in.
I think you should try it sometime. This thinking thing might not be so bad.
Stop making it sound like I don't.
You just said it yourself. No thinking, no nothing.
I was talking about before, you spoon.
Sorry, who are you calling a spoon?
Oh, shut up. If you're gonna act like a spoon, of course I'm gonna call you one.
It takes one to know one.
What?
Let's just chill out here, you guys.
Okay, then why don't you tell me where we are now? What's this region? Come on, spill. See? You can't tell your ass from your elbow. Doesn't that make you the spoon?
Just because I slept through that class. If I'd been awake for it,
right.
Then...
things were easier.
Then stay awake, you spoon!
Yeah. We had everything handed to us. Back then.
That's not quite true in your case, though, is it?
What?
You had thoughts, and deep ones at that. I can tell. When we're playing together.
But you have, as well.
I hope we find an answer.
Absolutely. We'll find it, I'm sure.
The answer to many questions that many people have been searching for. We will find them! Sooner than you might think, hopefully. Anyway.
The Podesto Valley floor is ahead.
Thank you, Tyon, for that.
The camp's a stone's throw from the Great Sword.
I think it's a bit further away than that. Or, well, actually. No, it actually literally is a stone's throw away. Alright, that's a lot closer than I gave it credit for. I thought we... honestly, for some reason, I thought it was, like, way further on the other side of the ocean in that direction. Apparently, Lance is not the only one who is, directionally challenged and slept through geography class. Lord knows, geography is not my most, powerful, dedicated, good... I was not good at reading maps, okay? That's perfectly fine.
Hey, guys!
Hmm?
It's an honor. I mean, this chance to do an op with you guys.
What do you mean?
You're my heroes. Ouroboros. I mean, I always knew a grunt like me could never measure up. Although, we all still dreamed of it. And now you're here in the flesh. Doesn't seem real.
What's so great about us?
Huh?
Before this op's done, we might have to kill old friends. How about it? Could you do it? Stab a friend?
Lance!
I mean, that's...
if you're here with some half-assed notions, go home.
I'm sorry. I just got excited.
They talk big, but when shit hits the fan, they might just double-cross us. You watch.
You saying you can't trust us with the job?
100%. You never trained with our unit before. never ever fought by our side. Way I see it, you're just some arsewipes who stole away what was rightfully ours.
Oh yeah? If I let you down, shoot me. In the front or back, I don't care.
Gee, thanks. Well, that's awful big of you, pal.
I'm sorry. Maybe we shouldn't have come.
No, this is good. It's how you build trust. You can only begin once you've gotten everything out in the open.
Really?
One of my dad's favorite lines. Wasn't it the same for you lot?
Yeah, you might be right on the mark.
I'm sure they'll settle down when they need to. They've got good role models today.
Can only sort through things when you got everything out in the open. That's pretty good advice, Monica. Your old man definitely had something going for him. And I'm not just saying that because I've played Xenoblade Chronicles 2. I know Guernica Vandom. And he was a top-notch guy. Hopefully, that we don't actually have to resort to shooting anyone, though. Because if we did, well, we all know who would come out on top, and that would not look good on anyone's conscience. Can we avoid all of these caterpillars? Yeah, we can. All right, Izzard. I hate to say that we have more important things to do, but you're right. We shouldn't neglect stuff like this. If we see the husks, we absolutely should send them off. You're right about that. I'm just highly concerned. Again, those Mobius instincts, they are resonating something fierce at the moment, and that giant dome right between those crevasse walls definitely has stuff to raise concerns with. Monica, you better get ready, because I feel like that stuff is about to hit the fan any second now. So hopefully it turns out much better than our first quest today.
Our intel was right. There's quite a few of them.
But it's too quiet. There's barely any signs of life. They're probably all conked out.
The fewer sentries, the better for us.
Monica, the cradles are in that transport.
Yes, it's likely. Let's head down. If we go round from the right, we can approach unseen.
Roger that.
Sounds like a good strategy to me. Let's hop down these cliffs and do this as quickly and as quietly as possible. Cradle convoy shelter.
Let's try not to get ahead of ourselves.
Yeah, the second you say that things are going to be a cakewalk is the second that things really do hit the fan and that chocolate icing becomes something very much not chocolate icing. So hopefully you haven't just jinxed us.
What is this?
They're all empty! Monica! There's nothing in here! They're all empty!
Son of a... Report!
Same over here! We got cradles, but nothing in them!
Monica?
Did we just fall for a trap?
They've got us surrounded!
Cavesi troops?
Well, doesn't it suck to be you? Every little step you made turned out exactly as planned. Now us, we're an elite unit, the all-stars of Keves. You lot have been doing as you please for long enough. Right here, right now, we're gonna correct that little mistake. Garth! Oh! So you've actually heard of me. Guess I gotta give myself more credit than I thought.
Layla and Hoop!
Sparks. They look like they're in their early terms. That means...
they got reborn.
That adds up. This lot, soon after they moved to Colony 8, I hear they croaked.
Don't dare look down on us second-termers. We were chosen. We are the elite. Now, I don't know if you're lost numbers or what, but you're in our way, and for that, your heads are gonna roll!
Well, 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 talk about a blast from the past. Layla, Hoop, Garvel, everyone that we have had from our early terms and fought ourselves. Can you operate the camera properly, you stupid fool? Stop doing that. Press the right buttons. This is quite the twist. Normally, when it comes to reincarnated, reborn fighters, Mobius has taken to doing it in their older forms. Y and Kamiravi, Hacked, Wamba, Miyabi. Now they're reaching at the bottom of the barrel to get the likes of Garvel to fight us. Unfortunately for them, they are still unfortunately quite weak. Being second-termers, their bodies are simply not up to par when it comes to us. So let's focus down on who we've got. If you recall from the various memories and cutscenes of the game, Garvel has his sword, so he's definitely an attacker. I believe Layla is the defender. I think, yeah, she has her giant Lance-esque sword, her shield sword, which is definitely indicative of how much quicker, or well, how much slower compared to someone like Garvel that it takes to defeat her, but still, at level 47, we probably should have done this a lot sooner. It's not the biggest of deals. They do have a few equities fighting with them. I think they only have like two. Not the biggest of concerns in and of themselves. We're not going to worry about them overly much. Hoop is, I believe, their ranged support, as evidenced by the fact that they have a gun and the fact that they're already more than half dead. Little amounts of HP, yeah, they're completely defeated already. Minimal HP is the hallmark of any good healer, so not terribly concerned with all of the logistics of the fight. As long as you've been doing quests, you should be good.
Just finish him off already. I need that sweet, sweet life.
Finish him off.
Hurry, run him through. Go on. Kill him dead. That'll give me a good top-up, nice and easy. Gotta love this new flame clock the console was kind enough to give us. It's a belter! Oh.
It's a different color.
Yeah, that is no ordinary flame clock.
Back in my old colony, if some moron slowed you down, there was nothing you could do. Oh, you could kill him, sure. But you wouldn't get any life from it. But around here, that's all changed. Here, life is the privilege of the strong. The final survivor gets to take the whole snuffing cake!
Garvel.
You get it now, do you? The weaklings need to be taken out of the running, so give me some of that sweet life! I... you mudder!
You can call yourself elite all you want, but do moderate your expectations.
You're the same as ever, Garv. Only ever thinking of yourself.
How are you gonna win against us like that?
What the snuff is this? No one told us about these monsters.
You are not to hesitate.
Man!
Lady Consul!
I should have known.
Guess you can't have a Pharonis without a consul, eh?
My Ouroboros as well. I can't believe my luck. I suppose I ought to have prepared better still.
A woman?
You like my children? They're an Anti-City special unit. One that I have diligently raised and lavished with love myself. It has been backbreaking to educate them so. They'll have to earn much, much more life for me before they're done. I hate failed investments. So you see...
I'll take you brats out myself to protect mine!
The cruelty of Mobius truly does know no bounds. What once was the effects of the Flame Clock only being able to harvest life from their enemies is now apparently extending to even within their own colonies. What wonderful ways of encouraging a certain behavior. Incentive, that's the word. Sometimes my brain just does not connect the words. Unfortunately for Mobius H, you really stand no chance against us. We are several levels above you. Although I will say their debuffs are something to be aware of, because they do have, I believe it looks like it's a frost debuff, which is basically like, you know, a burn debuff or a poison debuff, except with a different sprite. So we don't have to worry about that. Unfortunately, again for them, we don't have much to worry about. There's only one of them, and Mobius H, besides doing their debuffs, doesn't have a lot of stuff going for her. Ice Maiden, I believe Ice Maiden is a single target one that does bind, as you can see from lands being bound. We don't have to worry much about that, though, because they are still, still immune. They are very much not immune to stuff like the breaks and the topples and the dazes, as well as the smashes, obviously. We don't have to worry about that. But I do think it's interesting for, like, a narrative to see, now that we know that Y is the one who is behind all of the flame clocks and all of those mechanics, I think it can you break out of this, Noah, please? It goes to show how deep and nuanced the different powers of, you know, like, the actually powerful Mobiuses are, like X and Y. Because we have seen several effects of the flame clocks from Y's sick head already. The normal ones, obviously, that's just the ones we've been exposed to the most, that most colonies are. You know, you fight your opponents, you harvest their life, and everything is that particular way. Like Lance himself said, back when things were simple, if not, you know, they weren't better, but they were definitely simpler. And then we had the Pharonises that were suited for Ethel and Kamaravi, where they were siphoned off of their own flame, their own sparks, their own life. And that was also the one that was for Colony Zero as well, where they had their Pharons. I suppose technically Ethel and Kamaravi's one would technically also be considered Pharons in that particular application of the word. And then we have this new one. We had the normal reds, the special purples, and now green, where they can even harvest life from the people of the city. And normally, the people in the city wouldn't actually have any life to give, because they are technically born outside of the normal... The normal system, being, you know, reborn in the cradles and everything like that. So it's definitely interesting. And then I will say that Mobius H is particularly sick making all of these second termers do it. I mean, like, as much as we love Garvel, I really wouldn't wish this kind of fate on him. No, I would not. Though I will say, this fight has been going on quite long enough, so I think we can just draw Lucky 7 and get this chain attack going, and we should be fine. Or, well, I'm not going to do a chain attack, but you know, it'll be more than good enough. Invincible. Ice Maiden, does that give her brief invincibility? No, she's targeting me, which is why I'm invincible, because Lucky 7 does grant us invincibility. Blizzard Stream, that is a multi-hit move against someone, I believe. Luckily for us, they're targeting lands, and they're in their more Ouroboros form, so we don't have to worry about that, which is good. Why isn't Final Lucky 7's going off? Have we not been doing that pretty well for ourselves? Evidently not. I mean, it's still not that big of a deal. Right, 50 seconds. Do another... Yeah, we'll just do one more tachyon slash, and then we can take care of this. Yeah, just finish this off with a chain attack really quickly, please. Wonderful Noah, deal with this. Now that we have Izzard on the party, we should be more than good. Use tachyon slash. Get rid of this. Bring Izzard along for the ride. That should bring us up to, like, 68. Izzard should be able to bring us up to 150, get us both back, and then Noah can take care of everything else. Having Noah with this setup, with, you know, the ability to draw Lucky Sevens really quickly thanks to Ethel's class, paired up with someone like Izzard, who can technically guarantee you to get, you know, two people back, Izzard himself and well as someone else, is a very potent combo, especially in the late game. So I highly recommend playing around with different skill sets like that, because it is very powerful indeed. Because if you can get up high enough quickly... Like, Noah is the only one who's attacking right now, so he's guaranteed to come back, even though it's only 100%. So it is very good for damage if you can pile it on, especially if you're, like, building into, like, critical hits or just pure damage. It's very handy, I will definitely say. Noah, do again, tachyon slash. Just keep pounding this out. 13,000 damage every time. It's just an incredibly powerful move. You really cannot do much better than Lucky Sevens. Noah is definitely one of the most powerful party members that you can have when he's... Well, at the very least, when he has Lucky Sevens out. And since that's an ability he can use regardless of class, it's definitely something to keep in mind. Even when you're doing Noah as, like, a healer or even a defender, having that utility to go straight into, like, real powerful offense... It's really good for synergy in some team compositions. But this is already over. Right now we're just in it for the bonus EXP, which is, you know, incredible as always. Death of a Thousand Cuts. Noah, just take care of this once more with Tachyon Slash. You can really build up the TP. And this is just using Noah himself. This is not even doing, like, a super incredibly optimized chain attack setup with the, like, healers and, like, getting it real close to 99% before using Noah. This is just straight damage. But unfortunately for Mobius H, it's still an absolute obliteration. So let's wrap up this fight, and hopefully we can break this flame clock and save some of these second termers. If we can save Layla, Hoop, and even Garvel, that would be the best case scenario, I imagine.
What is this? Nobody told me the Ouroboros whelps were so horribly strong! Why did no one tell me?
Dear, oh dear. It seems your grasp has exceeded your reach.
Noah! Cut the flame clock! We gotta release Garv and the others!
This simply isn't fair!
What just happened? The Consul,
She just disappeared. Lady Consul? Lady Consul? What am I supposed to...
Drop it, Garv! Your clock's gone! Just stand down. Peace. You don't have to fight anymore. No more stealing of lives. No more charity from consuls.
What are you on about? Get snuffed. You're talking out your arse. Don't have to fight. Fighting is all that we know. If we don't have that, then what the snuff are we supposed to do? Tell me! What do we do now?
Hey, need some help?
Huh? Ah, yeah. Nah. Been through worse. Man, you guys. Stunning. You're so far beyond us.
Ah, it's not a big deal. If you're one of us, you'd do just as well.
Think they'll be okay, those guys?
What's eating you, Lance?
Well, I just worry we cut them loose a bit soon.
Tell me, what are we gonna do now?
How would I know?
Huh?
You stop stealing lives. You guard them. It's simple. But the how is up to you. Got it?
Spark? You can't do this to us.
Colony 4. Know it?
Yeah. I've heard about it.
On your map, middle of the Faunus region. The lieutenant there, Boliaris. You can tell him we sent you. Try him. Helps to have a mentor, starting out.
You gave him the info. Now they got a choice. Some might take it hard, though.
Besides, when we cut through the flame clock, it was to protect the city detachment, too. There was little else we could do.
If we'd meddled even more, it might have come right back round to bite us in the bum.
We did the right thing by telling them about Colony 4. I think that was the best course of action.
Everything they believed came crashing down just like that. They'll be confused for a while, sure. But they'll figure it out. Just the same as you lot did.
We might have gotten off lightly. If we hadn't met like we did in that valley, we'd be just as confused as those guys. Luck was on our side. Speaking of, back then, wasn't it Lance who was the most reluctant of us?
Nah. Our big man was just a bit shy to introduce himself in front of new people, right?
Shut up.
Oh, yeah, he was. I did kind of get the impression that he was embarrassed to speak up.
Right, eh? Oh, he's just a big teddy bear, really.
Same dish as mine. Double Arden meat, deluxe.
Ah, thanks a bunch.
Oh, Lessie, no tall spice here, but double veggies.
Arden sausage, huh? That sounds good. But then, there's the tall spice sauce as well. Fluff cream and skeeter syrup dressing. What delight. Oh, there's even chocolate sauce. How can I possibly choose?
Still hard to believe, huh? Eating what we want.
Huh?
But is it enough? I want more.
Dude, that's already pretty hefty. You really gonna eat another? Oh, hey. Whoa, he's pretty decent.
Or have I got it backwards?
Huh?
Maybe it has to start with me.
Quest complete. Side story, Lands. Lands and the others took part in a mission to liberate Cradles alongside the Lost Numbers, unexpectedly reuniting with Garvel in the process. The class limit of Lands has been broken. We can now get to level 20 with the Heavy Guard, which is very, very good for us. What a wonderful little side story, Lands. It is always a pleasure, a privilege, and an honor to side quest with you. That was very good. That was wonderful. I'm very glad to have gotten Lance's side story out of the way. Well, not out of the way. I'm glad to have done it. It was good. We've got new ties and strong friendships with another contingent of soldiers from the city's ranks, and that is always a good thing. We need all of the allies we can get. So, that is unfortunately going to be it for this episode. That was a wonderful one, if I do say so myself. We learned a lot about ourselves. We need to make change from within, that even though things might have been simpler in the past, and things might be really confusing and difficult to deal with in the present, we can still strive to do and be better. So, with that, whether you watched for 30 seconds or the entire thing, thank you so much for tuning in, and I will see you in the next episode of Xenoblade Chronicles 3 for more antics, side quests, and perhaps even ascension quests. Later!